क्लासिकल ग्रुप्स एंड रिप्रेजेंटेशन थ्योरी की इस सेमिनार में आप सभी का स्वागत है। पिछले महीने 12 तारीख से हम लोगों ने ये सेमिनार शुरू किया था और पहले ये सेमिनार हफ्ते में दो दिन हो रहा था, लेकिन पिछले हफ्ते हम लोगों ने तय किया कि हम लोग हफ्ते में एक दिन शुक्रवार को, फ्राइडे को इस सेमिनार को करेंगे। पिछली बार की रिकॉर्डिंग हम एडिटेड फॉर्म में नहीं भेज पाए हैं, आज के सेमिनार के साथ ही हम इस रिकॉर्डिंग को भी भेज देंगे। और आप सबसे बार बार हम अनुरोध कर रहे हैं कि अगर संभव है तो आपके सवाल हो तो उन सवालों से ही सर अगर शुरुआत करेंगे तो हम सभी को अच्छा लगेगा, विशेष रूप में सर को। तो हम सर से ये अनुरोध करते हैं कि वो आज का अपना व्याख्यान शुरू करें। सर,
ओके स्वप्निल, और मैं चाहूंगा कि ये आप सब लोग अपने कुछ इट बी ए लिटिल इनफॉर्मल ऑल्सो, और हम लोग कुछ चीज़ों को डिस्कस कर सकते हैं। कभी कभी मैं ऐसा लगता है कि कुछ बताते हुए निकल जाता हूँ, ऐसा लगता है कि ये सब शायद क्लियर हो तो मैं नहीं समझ पाता हूँ, कुछ एक्सप्रेशन में कुछ दर्द भी हो जाता होगा। तो आप लोग उसको उस पर कुछ क्वेरी कर सकते हैं, कुछ डिस्कस कर सकते हैं, और इनफॉर्मली डिस्कस करें तो ज़्यादा अच्छा रहेगा। चीज़ें और ये बेसिकली अभी तो मैट्रिक्स थ्योरी, अभी तो क्लासिकल ग्रुप्स मोर और लेस इंट्रोड्यूस हो जाएंगे, हो रहे हैं और करीब करीब हो जाएंगे, और इनकी थोड़ी सी अलजेब्रिक प्रॉपर्टी हो रही है, उसके बाद टोपोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टी एज लिटिल बिट ऑफ लीनियरली ग्रुप्स करके फिर हम लोग रिप्रेजेंटेशन थ्योरी पर चलेंगे। तो आप लोग कुछ अगर डिस्कस करना चाहें तो डिस्कस कर सकते हैं आज भी। और ये जो है ये नहीं आया है क्या, ये दूसरा
सर एकदम प्लेन खुल गया है, वो पुराना नहीं है,
तो इसका मतलब व्हाइट बोर्ड दूसरा खुल गया है
जी।
ये जो है ये बार है, शायद ये खुल जाए तो अच्छा होगा। ये जूम का अलग व्हाइट बोर्ड आ जाता है
जी, बिल्कुल।
अब ये माइक्रोसॉफ्ट का वन नोट अब शायद आ रहा है, तो ये
अभी नहीं आया सर, उसको मिनिमाइज करिए।
अच्छा, इसको मिनिमाइज किया हमने, ये व्हाइट बोर्ड अभी नहीं आया।
नहीं सर, अभी नहीं आया।
पहले इसको स्टॉप शेयर करिए,
इसको स्टॉप शेयर करें। अच्छा, पहले स्टॉप शेयर करें और अब फिर शेयर स्क्रीन करें और ये खोल लें पहले इसको, और है फिर ये गड़बड़ हो गया है, और अब इसको मैं स्टॉप शेयर, इसको फिर मैं शेयर स्क्रीन, और ये आई ये आ गया
जी, आ रहा है। हाँ, आ गया है। हाँ बिल्कुल।
तो इसमें हम लोगों ने कुछ चीजें थोड़ी सी हाइपरजर्डी भी शायद की थी, एक मिनट रहा है, तो थोड़ा सा फिर से मैं रिकॉल करूंगा। आप लोग कुछ डिस्कस करना चाहें डिस्कस करें इसके बारे में, चीजें आसान है ये सब चीजें, लेकिन ये थोड़ा सा मैट्रिक्स थ्योरी और सब इन्वॉल्व है, तो और क्योंकि ये रिप्रेजेंटेशन थ्योरी करेंगे तो उसमें तो थोड़ा यूज होगा। और सो इफ यू वांट टू डिस्कस समथिंग, कुछ आप लोग क्वेरी हो, कुछ सजेशंस हो, हम थोड़ा सा बहुत कभी कभी हैफेज आउट हो जाता है, तो प्लीज बियर विद मी। तो आप लोग कुछ कहना चाहें तो कहें। या मैं फिर से रिकॉल कर लेता चल रहा हूँ। सो फॉर व्हाट वी हैव डन इज द फॉलोइंग, वी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड bilinear forms, non-degenerate and maybe bilinear forms, and corresponding classical groups. So for example, we introduced this ON as a group, the group of matrices which keep this form invariant. So A belonging to GL and R such that XA, YA, and this is the Euclidean inner product, the form, the positive, the unique positive definite form on Rn, non-degenerate positive form inner product on Rn, such that this is equal to X bar, Y bar for every X, Y. So this is the orthogonal group, and we discussed some properties of this. So that is something which we have already done here. So this is, and then we introduced UN as a group of as a group which keeps the unitary inner product invariant. So that was A belonging to GL and C such that X bar A and Y bar A, and this is the Euclidean, this is the unitary inner product, which is your XY vector, says that XY for every XY belonging to CN. So this was also a form, non-degenerate positive definite Hermitian form on CN, and UN was the group which keeps this form invariant. And the properties of these groups we have already discussed. And then we also discussed the we also described the symplectic group SP2NR, and this 2NR. So this was this is the matrix. This is the group of matrices A belonging to GLN2R, SGL2NR. Such that, so let me define the symplectic product. Let me call that to be X bar A, Y bar A, and let me call this in symplectic form. This to be equal to XY for every XY belonging to R to the power 2n. So what was this symplectic form? That let me just define symplectic form. This was defined to be, indeed X bar, that X bar belongs to R2n. So this is R2n, X bar. And then you look at this J2n, and Y bar transpose. So this is the form where what is J2N. So remember J2N is simply the matrix of this form, 2N cross 2N matrix of this form, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And then here, this in this diagonal, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. In the diagonal, this block of 2 cross 2 matrices are there, and this is 0, 0. Or you may also take it, this is also congruent to this form, which you can call to be J2N dash, which is your this form, 0, N cross N matrix, N cross N 0 matrix. And here is your identity, N cross N matrix, minus identity, let me say here. And here is your identity, N. This is comfortable for me. So this is N cross N 0 matrix. So this is also there. So what one does here is that these two are congruent to each other. Why? Because you can just change, use the permutation matrices to shift it minus one somewhere so that it becomes minus one in its upper diagonal and one in the diagonal. So these two are indeed congruent. So therefore, this you can also define as J2n. You can take at the place of J2n, you can take J2n as also. So this is symplectic group. That is something which we described last time. And you can describe what is SP2R. Say, for example, SP2R, for just to have an example, you can describe SP2R very element, using this thing, you can describe this SP2R. We shall discuss the properties of this maybe later. So this is what is called symplectic group. And we also observe, so this is also something which we observe, and the observation is this, that you take UN. So what we can do here, sometimes the complex matrices are involved here. So we convert complex matrices into the real matrix using this idea. So from C to R2, you have this correspondence that we have already described, X plus IY. This is mapped to X minus Y, and here X. So this is the map from C to R2, and C to M2R, C to M2R. Right, C to M2R. So this is the set of 2x2 matrices. You map X plus IY to this 2x2 matrix, and this is an injective ring homomorphism. C can be thought of as a subfield of M2R through this identification. And indeed, using this identification, one can easily observe that if you a complex matrix A can be mapped to another matrix, which is your, let me, that perhaps we described as Psi A. So A is a n cross n complex matrix. So Psi A is a 2n cross 2n real matrix. What it does is the following. Indeed, this matrix does the following. If you take Aij here, if you take Aij here, so Aij is equal to some Bij plus I times Cij, right? And then Psi A is the matrix which is obtained by putting this at the place of Aij, you put this block 2x2, block of 2x2 real matrix, that is your Bij minus Cij through this map here, Cij, and Cij and Bij. So this is what you do. You put Aij in ith row or jth column. Now it is two, you can think as a block of 2x2 matrices, which I and the so this is M2R, M2NR can be thought of as a block of 2x2N cross N matrices with each row entry in M2R, and that member M2R is described as here. So Aij is a complex matrix here. So Aij will be something like this, Bij plus Icij. So in ith row, this you can put in the ith row and jth column. In ith row, so each entry is a block of 2x2 matrix, and in ith row and jth column. So this is you can think of that Mn of M2R, n cross n matrices with entries in 2x2 matrices. So that is the identification here. And if you do this identification, then this gives you a map from MnC to MnC to M2NR, and this is also
an injective ring homomorphism. So M and C can be thought of as a subring of M2 and R through this identification. It is not surjective. What is the image? So you can describe the image. This map also I'm denoting by psi. So psi M and C can be described as follows. Psi M and C can be described as the set of 2n cross 2n matrices A belonging to M2 and R. M2 and R such that A J2, which we described earlier, the 2 cross 2 block matrices here, this is J2N here, J2N, so that J2N, J2N commutes with J2. So this is the matrix here. And you can see here that under this correspondence, A star will correspond to psi A transpose. So A bar transpose will correspond to psi A transpose. You just map this block, 2 plus 2 black block matrices, take bar. So you see, using this, it will convert into the transpose. Say X minus I, Y, where will it go? It will go to the transpose of this. X minus I, Y will go to minus, here you'll be getting Y, and here you'll be getting minus Y. So this is transpose. So this actually, this psi takes the star to the transpose in a way, right? So that is the this thing. So therefore, you see here, so using this identification, we have observed that U2N, U2N through this map, UN to O2N. So what will happen? A star identity identity will be indeed psi A transpose identity, and psi A is 2n cross 2n matrix. So A is a unitary matrix and psi A is a 2n cross 2n matrix. And since, because of this observation, if this is this, then this is this. So therefore, you see that it will go into O2n. So UN can be thought of as a subgroup of O2n, but it is also not surjective. And the image is obtained as here. And if you take the image here, it is, if you take a member A, which is in O2N, and it also satisfies this property, that will also mean, so A belonging to AJ2N equal to J2N A, and A transpose is identity. If you combine these two things, then you will see that the members A here will also satisfy the property. So this will actually be equivalent to say that AJ2N, A transpose is J2N. Right, so that is, so A to N intersection, and such matrices, you remember, that was defined to be, so J2N, which gives the form J2N, the symplectic form invariant. So therefore, this is really a symplectic group. So this is symplectic group, SP2N R. Symplectic group can be defined on any over any field, but anyway, here we have taken this to be R. So that is the thing which we have already observed, and we also talked about some properties of SU2 and how SU2 was observed. So so for that we SU2 we described this the Hamiltonian ring, Hamiltonian algebra, the quaternion algebra AH, which is your A0 plus A1i plus A2j plus A3k, where AI belong to R here. And we shall confuse this H with R4. So through this map, A0, A1, A2, A3, 3 goes to A0 plus A1i plus A2j plus A3k, and the product, the sum is the coordinate wise product is I square is equal to Z square is equal to K square is equal to minus 1 and so on, which we already know. So that is the quaternion algebra R4 here. And this H can also be thought of as, you see, C plus Cj. Cj. So what is this? This is your say, suppose A0 plus A1i plus A2 plus A3i into j. Right? So here the elements are of the type, just as a complex number is obtained with the help of two pairs AB, A and B real numbers. So similarly here, this is a complex number, one complex number, this is one complex number, and multiply with this J. And this is your simply, this you required A0 plus A1i plus A2j plus A3k. So there is a philosophy behind these constructions, as we shall discuss while doing this Clifford group or spin group in Clifford algebra. So we shall discuss that. So A3 and ij is another coordinate. So you can put this ij to be equal to k. And so what you have here is H can be thought of. So AB goes to A plus BJ. A plus bj, a is a complex number, b is a complex number, a plus bj, it is in H, and you see that this is a C linear map, is a C linear map. So it's a vector C isomorphism of considered as a complex vector space. So this A plus this H can be considered as a complex vector space multiply from left the A plus Bi. Indeed, what you can see here is that the complex field is a subfield of H. Is a subfield of H. The product addition product is a subfield of H. So therefore, H can be thought of as a vector space over C of dimension 2. And explicitly, this is the C2 is also a vector space of dimension 2 over C. And C2 and H are isomorphic under AB goes to A plus BJ. So this is C isomorphism. So this is C isomorphism, complex vector space. So just as in case of from C to R, so from C to R, how we converted C to R, what was the map? A goes to A plus BI goes to AB and A minus BB and A. So similarly here also, we can have the correspondence from MNH. So what is MNH? MNH is the set of all n cross n matrices with entries in the quaternion algebra, in the quaternion algebra R4, MNH. And you know that, so let me make some observation here. MNH to M2NC. We have this map, so let me call this eta map. So that map A goes to A, any map A here, how it goes to? It goes to AB, A is equal to B plus JC, B plus CJ, B plus CJ here. Any element, any entry can be written as B plus C, B, I, J. So any entry, any matrix with entries in H can be written as this, where B is a complex matrix and C is a complex matrix. So remember how we identified C with the 2 plus 2 matrices. So if you do the same identification here, you can map it to this A. And minus B bar here, in R, the involution was identity, so that is not there. So here it is minus B. Instead of minus B, it is minus B bar, and B bar, B and A bar. So this is this is B, and this is minus C bar, and this is C, and this is B bar, right? B bar. So A plus BJ. So A plus BJ goes to B minus C bar, C B bar. So this is what B is a n cross n complex matrix. C is a n cross n complex matrix. So this is again a member of M2NC here. So therefore you get a map from MNH to M2NC here. And this is the correspondence here, and we discuss some group over here over H. Now remember, H is a division algebra. It is not a commutative field. It is not a commutative field, but still you can do linear algebra on this. You can talk of, say, left vector spaces. You can talk of right vector spaces. So if you talk of left vector spaces, so any, you see, if D is a division ring, you know, if D is a division ring, any finitely generated module over D is a free module. So you have a concept of basis there, and invariant, the number of elements in a basis is invariant, that is the dimension. You can talk of the dimension. The only thing is that you have to be either left, consider the left vector space or the right vector space. So that is M and H here. And so therefore M and H can be thought of, M and H can be thought of as the set of all H linear transformations from H to the power N. So H to the power N to H to the power N. So M and H can be thought of as a linear H linear map from H to the power N to H to the power N, where H is quaternion. So this is M and H, and that will give you a matrix representation. Here also you can talk of basis member, the same basis member, your usual basis member is extended to any extension field, you know, given a basis member, a basis of a real vector space, then you complexify by taking the same basis and extending the scalar to the complex or to any field, any extension. So similarly, H is R is contained here, C is also contained here, and E1, E2, EN is a basis, extended basis, so that basis can be considered over here also. So it's extending the scalar, so to say. So H to the power N to H to the power N, the transformation from H to the power H to the, to this, so H to the power N is this matrix M and H. And remember here, on H to the power N also we have a form. And what is that form? Just as the unitary inner product was there on C to the power N, we have another form here also. So what is this? You take X bar to be a vector here. So they're all quaternions. And Y bar is another quaternion here. So Y bar is another quaternion vector Y1, Y2, Yn. So then I defined X bar, Y bar, and the symplectic product or the product for corresponding to this H in Hn, which is the sigma, which is your, you can take X bar here and you take the identity and Y bar. Okay, so Y bar star transpose, or what you can call bar transpose. So what is a bar here? You we have, see, if you Q is a quaternion A0 plus A1i plus A2j plus A3k, then you have the bar of this, the conjugate of this is A0 minus A1i minus A2j minus A3k. And you can see that QQ bar is simply the norm of the Q. Q is square. So norm of Q is square. So this is called the conjugate. So take Y, the conjugate of each entry here, and then take the transpose. So that is the thing here. And so we are taking this identity, which is the positive definite form extended to this this here. So that is so this simply means that this is equal to sigma xi bar yi bar, and again this bar y by I bar as a vector, xi and yi bar, xi yi bar, xi yi bar. So what is yi bar? Yi is a quaternion like this, and you take it's a conjugate. So xyh is equal to this. So that is the product here, here. And if you look into the group, so then you talk of the symplectic group. This we call to be the symplectic group, SPN with on the Hamiltonian, the quaternion symplectic group. SPNH is equal to what? This is equal to the set of matrices A belonging to G, L, and C. M and C. It will turn out to be in GL and H. It will be in GL and H, such that X bar A and Y bar A, X bar and Y bar are the vectors in H to the power N. This is the symplectic product, the quaternion product here, H here, and that is the X bar Y bar. So if you consider this, then this is SPNH. So for example, if you look into SP1H, what will be SP1H? So SP1H is simply cross one matrix, and Q bar Q. So this is what? This is simply Q belonging to H, such that Q bar Q is equal to one. So this is actually what this simply means that let me make it explicit here in form of matrix. So this is for every xy, right, belong to H to the power N. So therefore this will simply mean that A into A star transpose, A bar, you know what is A bar. A is a quaternion matrix. So therefore, bar of each entry is there, and then take the transpose. So this is equivalent as usual to say that this is A, such that A bar transpose is identity matrix. In four cross four n matrix over R, and 2n cross 2n matrix over complex field. So that is this is SPN. So what will be this Q bar transpose of 1 cross 1 matrix is 1. So this is equal to 1. And what is this? This is just the unit quaternion, and this is your SU2, or this is your S3, which is identified with SU2. This is identified with SU2. So this is the symplectic. So this is a symplectic group, and you can, as in case of from complex to real, you can easily, or you can also observe that SPNH can be considered as can be identified where the 2n cross 2n matrices with entry in the complex field, and that is precisely A minus B bar A bar, right? Such that this type of matrices, such that this is also a member of U2N. So this belongs to U2N, U2NC. U2N. So actually, unitary matrix means the complex matrix. So this is this. So that is SPNH. It can be seen, you can observe here also. So this is the symplectic group with the entries in the quaternion group. So we may have time to discuss with these things. Let me make one more observation here. So this is SU2, which is your S3. So I wish to say something here, which will indeed referred, maybe which will be discussed in more detail maybe sometimes later. So that is this, you know. So if you take S3 here, S3 is SP1, and which is also S2, which is a unit quaternion. So S3, you take Q belonging to S3, and look at identify R3 with pure quaternions. pure quaternions. So quaternions, q equal to a0 plus a1i plus a2j, so plus a3k. So a0 is real part, and this is a quaternion part. So say maybe pure quaternion part. So identify R3 with pure quaternions H dash, let me write here. So H dash is what? H dash is the elements of this type a1i plus a2j plus a3k. So this is identified with R3 through this map. And then what you do here, define a map FQ from H dash, that is R3 to R3. So I'll write H dash, but treat this is R3. This is R3. Every element H dash is a member of R, is defined as a unique member of R3. So to this, we define a map. And what is that map? FQ of any element here. So let me, that is the unit quaternion here. That is the quaternion here, pure quaternion. So quaternion is a member of H. So you take Q A bar, which is a quaternion, Q inverse. Here Q is a member of S3, unit quaternions, so that is invertible. So QA, so this is something like inner conjugation on the quaternion algebra H restricted to the pure quaternion part. You observe that if A is a pure quaternion, this is also a pure quaternion. No real part will appear here. If A bar has no real part, then this will also have no real part. So this is the a mapping from FQ to this thing. And it is obviously a linear transformation, because if A bar plus B bar, you write here, distributive product distributes. So this is a linear transformation. It is invertible because FQ inverse is the inverse of FQ. So this is an automorphism of H dash. And furthermore, you see that FQ preserves length. You see FQ A bar, and look at its Euclidean knob, FQ A bar is what? That is equal to, so remember, so this is equal to Q norm of Q A bar, Q inverse norm. And I think we have observed that this is a normed algebra. You can prove that A into B ka agar norm hai, to norm of A into norm of B hoga. So therefore, you can write it as a norm of Q into norm of A bar into norm of Q inverse, and in the so this will, so this is in R now, so it commutes, so therefore this will be identity, and this is your A bar here. So therefore FQ preserves length, and once a linear transformation preserves length, it is a member of the orthogonal group. So FQ belongs to orthogonal group O3, am I right? FQ belongs to orthogonal group O3. It's a transformation. It's a linear map which takes which preserves norm length. And you know that such a transformation is an orthogonal transformation because it will also preserve the distances. So FQ belongs to O3. So therefore, now this defines. A map F from S3 to O3, S3 to O3. And what is that map? FQ is equal to F of Q. This is a map. And you see, it's a kind of inner automorphism kind of thing. So it is obviously a homomorphism. So it is a homomorphism. F is a homomorphism. F is a homomorphism. F is a homomorphism of group. Obviously, it is continuous also. When we come to the topology case, it's a continuous also. So this is a continuous, indeed continuous also, continuous. So there is topology on S3, usual topology, and a topology on O3 is also there. So this is a continuous homomorphism from FQ. Now, what is its kernel? Observe, kernel of Q, kernel of F is what? So kernel of F is those quaternions Q such that Q, pure quaternion Q of A bar is a pure quaternion, Q is inverse, is equal to A. For every belonging to H dash, the pure quaternion, right? So in particular, if you take Q is your A0 plus A1i plus A2j plus A3k. And so this means that Q bar A is A bar A cube, I'm writing as a vector, no? So A bar, so Q A bar, Q inverse is, so that means Q A bar is A bar Q, it commutes with each vector here. So that means it commutes with I also, pure quaternion, I. So that Q into I is equal to I into Q, and Q into J is equal to J into Q. Write down the equations and you see that this will imply that A2 will vanish because I is here. So A2 will be minus A2. K A3 will be minus A3. So A2 and K3 will vanish. And similarly, this will imply that A1 vanish. So it is in A0. So Q will become A0. And since we are in S3, it's a map from S3, Q is a member of S3. So A0 is a unit, a real unit quaternion that is plus or minus one. So therefore, this is one or minus one. This is one or minus one. So kernel of this is 1 or minus 1. So you see that you have a mapping from S3 to O3 and F, and here is your kernel. Kernel is 1 minus 1. S3 to O3, in kernel is 1 minus 1 here, right? Okay, so one more thing, let me observe. So I'm using a little topology, but the statement I'm giving you, and maybe we'll discuss it in more detail, a little bit of topology I'm using here. I thought that I would not use topology, only do the direct property, but sometimes it is needed. So this is S3 to O3, and this can be done with a little clumsy calculation also, but let me give this argument. S3 to O3, F is a map, and you see that S3 is a connected topological space, connected group. This is a connected group, right? This is connected group. S3 sphere is connected, you know, because any two points can be joined through a arc, the greater circle arc or whatever it may be. So you can S3 is a path connected space indeed, is a connected space, and F is a continuous map, and S3 is a group. O3 is also a group. So FS3 is a subgroup of O3, and it should be a connected subgroup of O3. It should therefore be a connected subgroup of O3. And O3, you know, is not connected because determinant map takes it to plus minus one. So the connected component of identity here is SO3. Connected component of identity is SO3. SO3 is connected, you know. SO3 is connected. How SO3 is connected? How SO3 is connected? So how SO3 is connected? SO3 is connected simply because, you know, SL3 is connected. I'll come to this maybe. SL3R is connected, and Gram-Schmidt process just says that you have a retraction to SO3, and the retraction is a continuous. So this is connected. So therefore, this is also connected. Anyway, so this is connected. SO3 is connected subgroup. So therefore, the image should be contained in a connected subgroup, which is a maximal connected subgroup here, because O3 upon SO3 is a group of order 2. So therefore, this O3 has two connected components, SO3 and minus one into the second coset of this. So that is a connected subgroup here. So F, the image is in O3, SO3. So you have indeed S3, that map S goes inside SO3, F, and here is the kernel 1 minus 1. And here is one here, this thing. But still more is true here, that F is also surjective. How to interpret that? So you see here, so that again, I'm using a little topology, I'm sorry. Maybe these things will be done with the covering, has to be done. Anyway, I'll do this. So one minus one is what? Is a discrete subgroup of S3. So S3 over one minus one. To SO3, you have this F bar. which is injective homomorphism, because this was the kernel. So this is an injective homomorphism, and this is a discrete subgroup. And now I'm considering the dimension, looking into the dimension consideration. S3 is a manifold is of dimension 3. You know, S3 is of dimension 3, and this is a discrete subgroup. So quotienting with the discrete subgroup will not change. This is of dimension 0. You know, G by H, the dimension of G by H is dimension of G minus dimension of H, and dimension of H is here is 0, because this is a discrete subgroup. So this, the dimension of H3 over this is 3, and dimension of SO3 is also 3. Because you look into the conditions defining SO3, so the dimension of O3 and SO3, both of them are of dimension 3, because O3, 1 minus 1 is SO3. So this is of dimension 3, and this is a subgroup of dimension 3 of SO3. And as such, it has to be equal to F bar, it has to be equal. So therefore, this is surjective. So I'm sorry, I have used a little bit of topological arguments, but forget if you have not remember the result, which is important here. So this is the subgroup. And I'll give you another construction of this for general cases. So that means H3 is a double cover of this. Indeed, this is the covering group of SO3. Covering group of SO3, and the kernel is a group of order 2, which indeed, using the topological consideration, simply say that fundamental group of SO3 is Z2, but forget about it. So this is the group SO3 to SO3 to this. This is indeed we'll have you see what one can see here, that SON is also a group for n greater than or equal to 3, not for 2 here. SO2 is S1, you know, right? So SON also has a universal cover, and there is a double covering here also, because the fundamental group of this is Z2. So there is something, there is some construction using topology covering space theory. But we'll be giving you another construction, which is a purely algebraic one, and using the preferred techniques. So I'll be giving a similar kind of construction, the kind of which is what is called the spin group, or the spin group. So there is a spin group of L, spin N, and a surjective homomorphism from here to here, and this. So that I'll do when doing this. So maybe soon. So that is the thing which is there. Now, last time I also described quickly the Lorentzian geometry. So I'll again do that for you quickly again. So this was about the forms, those forms, the Euclidean inner product, the unitary inner product, the symplectic inner product, and the groups coming out of those groups, and some relationship between those groups. So that we have discussed here. Now I'm coming to the forms which are not positive definite, which is your. So you remember that on Rn, we have the skew symmetric forms, the symmetric forms, non-degenerate symmetric forms are of the determined by the signature PQ, and it is your given by 1 1 1, say P times, and so incidentally I'll just conveniently I'll take -1 first, and then 1 1 1 last time. So this is Q, this is your Q, and this is your P times this. So this is your J, maybe you can write JQP is the matrix, the diagonal matrix, whose first Q diagonal entries are -1, and the rest of the diagonal entries are, so this is a non-degenerate symmetric bilinear form on Q. So this will also, give you a form, so non-degenerate form, what will be that? That will be, that is given by X bar y bar. You can put here qp if you want, that is your x bar, and this is your jqp p and y bar transpose. So this is the form. And what is the group? The group is the group which I'll write as oqp. So incidentally I'll write to pq, that is convenient for me, but usually I'll take minus first. So opq is the group A belonging to G, L, N, R, such that A, J, P, Q, or Q, P, A transpose is equal to J, P. So that is the group here. And again, you can see that the determinant of A is plus one or minus one and so on. So for every PQ, you have such a group here. I'll maybe write QP. So we have such a group of QP, and determinant is plus or minus one. Again, you can talk of the special kind of the special thing with this, but I'm interested in the special case when Q is one and P is N. So I'm interested in O1N. Last time we described it, but I did it hurriedly. So O1N, so what is O1N? O1N is the group of the matrices, the A belonging to GN, GL n plus 1 R, such that A J 1 N A transpose is equal to J 1 N. Right? So this is the group O1 N, and O1 N is called a Lorentz group. This is called Lorentz group. And the form X bar y bar and the form which is obtained as here will write as L, and we shall call it to be the Lorentz form. So this is equal to X bar and J1N and X y bar transpose, which is what? Which is equal to minus 1 1, 1, 1, 1. So you see that this is your minus x1, y1 plus x2, y2 plus so on plus xn plus 1. So I'm taking n here. So so this n coordinates are here, yn plus 1, xn plus 1, yn plus 1, yn plus 1. So this is the form, and this we shall call to be the Lorentz inner product, Lorentz form or Lorentz inner product. This is not positive definite. So this is not inner product in the usual sense, but it is also termed as a product, Lorentz product, Lorentz inner product. So this is the Lorentz inner product. And then quickly again, I'll describe the things which we did last time. And that is, so R n plus 1, sometimes just to say that we are in this situation, we shall write R1n. So these two are confused sometimes. So Lorentz inner product is here. And then you have the Lorentz norm also. So what is the Lorentz norm? Norm, it is not norm in the usual sense. So that is your x bar bar L square is equal to x L, which is equal to minus x1 square plus x2 square plus xn plus 1 square. So this is Lorentz norm. And you know, there are these, this is not a indeed positive or negative. This may be negative, this may be zero, this may be positive. So last time we described here, I'm repeating that. So there are three cases. First, Lorentz XL squared is less than zero. This simply means that x1 square is greater than x2 square plus xn plus 1 square. In this case, we say that x bar is a time-like vector. the terminology coming from the physics, time-like vector. This is called time-like vector if this is the case. And second, if x L square is greater than zero, then we say that it is space-like. Means this is communicable and this is space-like vector. So that means x1 square is less than x2 square plus 1 plus xn plus 1 square. And the third case, it may be zero also. So x L square is equal to zero, means x bar is called light-like. Exactly your with the speed of light. So this is the this. So I'm interested in this case, the first case, which is the real one. So the time-like speed. Now we say that x bar is positive time-like. X bar is called positive time-like. You see, let TL the set of TL denote the set of time-like vectors. So you see that time-like vector, this is not a connected space, right? This is not a connected space. Why? It's not connected space because you see that x1, x2, xn plus 1 map to the projection map, the first projection x1 takes the members here to positive and negative both, because x1 square is here, positive and negative both. So TL is not a connected space. TL is not connected space. TL is not a connected space. But what I say here that let me call this TL plus to be the positive time-like spaces. So that means I'll be interested in X, said that X is a time-like, and X1, that X1 is greater than zero. X1 is greater than zero. So this is a positive time-like space, positive time-like vectors. So that is the time, and similarly, you can talk of the negative time-like vectors. Right? So this is time-like vector. Now you can easily observe that TL plus is a connected space. So how to say that TL plus is a connected space? So what you do here, so let us take X bar in time-like TL plus and Y bar TL plus, so path connected. Indeed, I'm showing that they are path connected spaces. So what we do here, we show here it's a convex space. In other words, TX plus 1 minus TY. So this is a path, sigma T. So sigma 0, let me put 1 minus TX, 1 minus TX plus TY. So if you put t equal to 0, it is x, and put t equal to 1, it is y, and t lying between 0 and 1. So 0 and 1, right? So this is all that we need to show is that if x and y belongs to this, this is contained in TL plus. This is contained in TL plus. So x bar, this is a path in TL plus, which is from x to y here, and that is very simple here. So x bar is a positive time-like space, right? X bar is a positive time-like space, and y bar is also a positive time-like space. And 1 minus t into ty. So first of all, you see that this 1 minus t is non-negative, and t is also 1 minus t is non-negative. At t equal to 1, at t equal to 0, it is 1, and t equal to 1, it is 0. So all that you have to show is the following, that if x is positive time-like, and t is greater than zero, then tx is also a positive time lag. That is very clear, because what if t is positive, so x bar is x1, x2, xn plus 1, such that x1 square is greater than x2 square plus xn is xn plus 1 square, plus 1 square. So you see that tx bar also has the similar property if t is greater than 0. Right, if t is greater than zero, and sum of two thing will also be a member. So if x bar and y bar belongs to x bar, y bar belongs to TL plus, then this implies that x bar plus y bar also belong to TL plus. How this is because so here x bar plus y bar is your x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2, and xn plus 1 plus yn plus 1. And we need to show that x1 plus y1 square is greater than x2 plus y2 square plus so on plus xn plus 1 plus yn plus 1 square. Provided x1 square, so here given that this x1 square is greater than this, y1 square is greater than y2 square plus yn square. So that is something which you have to show. So you see here that this is your x1 square plus y1 square plus 2x1 y1. And this is your x2 square plus y2 square plus x2 square plus xn plus 1 square and plus y2 square plus yn plus 1 square. A plus 2 times sigma xi yi, I equal to 2 to n plus 1. So that is the condition. And see that this thing, this plus this is already less than, this is already greater than this. Okay, so this is already greater than this. This is so x1 square plus y x1 square is greater than this, y1 square is greater than this part. And see here, sigma x, I use the Cauchy inequality. So Cauchy inequality, this will mean that this is less than or equal to sigma xi square into sigma yi square square root. And sigma xi square is automatically less than xi because these are positive. No, these are positive, x1, x2 positive. So sigma xi square is less than x1 and sigma y, so therefore this is there. So therefore this is, you see that this is a there. So this is a positive time like, so this is a connected space, T plus L is connected, path connected. Now you consider this O1N. So O1N was the group, the Lorentz group, which has the property that A, such that A, J, one, N, A transpose is equal to J1N. So that is the thing which is here. So O1N and right. So O1N, this is O1N and A, the map X goes to X bar A. First of all, so observe x bar, this preserves time lag. Why? Because x bar A and y bar A, L, this is the L inner product, is x bar, y bar. If A belongs to this, that is the definition of O1N. So that is x bar y for every L. It preserves that form. So this is x bar A, x bar y here. So if x is a time-like vector, x is a time-like vector, x bar A will be equal to x bar, x bar. So if x bar is a time-like vector, x bar A is also a time-like vector. So x bar goes to x bar A is maps time-like space to time-like space. So this maps TL to TL, right? And you need multiplication by a matrix is a continuous map. So it is a continuous map. And here we have two connected components. What is the connected component? T plus L union T minus L. As for T plus L, you can see that this is also a connected component. So this is a connected component, and here is your T plus L and unit T minus L. And this is a continuous map. So it will take a connected component to a connected component. So it may take T plus L to T minus L and T minus L to T plus L. You know, it's a bijective. So it will just, it may reverse these things. So what I consider only those matrices. So let PO1N denote the set A belonging to O1N, such that A takes T plus L to T plus L. It doesn't take T plus L to T minus L. So what is this? This is this means X bar A belongs to T plus L for every X bar belonging to T plus L. So it takes the positive time-like spaces, the upper part here, to the upper part here. So this is a PO1N, and you see that this is a subgroup of O1N of index 2, you can easily see. So this is PO1N is called, this is a subgroup. You multiply these things, it will satisfy the same property, positive to positive to positive. So therefore, this is called a positive Lorentz group. Positive Lorentz group. Sometimes we say we denote O plus 1N. So that is a positive Lorentz group. This is positive Lorentz group. And you see here that, I don't know whether I observed or not, O1N to the determinant map here is again your 1 minus 1 here, 1 minus 1 here, because, you know, A, J, 1, N, A transpose is equal to J1N. The determinant of J1N is minus 1. You see, J1N is not in O plus. J1N is what? J1N will take the positive X1 to minus. So this is not in O plus 1N. This is, though it is in O1N, it commutes, you know, J1N, J1N square, to identity map ho jayega, to J1N fit ho jayega ye. So therefore, this is a member of O1N, but it is not a member of this. This take positive to negative, negative to positive. So this is not. So this is determinant of this map is 1 and minus 1. And this is surjective also. And you have the splitting here, minus 1 actually coming to J1N. Is a splitting here, and this is the special orthogonal group. And if you apply P here, then P here, PSO and here, and this is this. So this, you get this exact sequence. So this is the really the group in which. Let me first discuss this positive Lorentz group. Positive Lorentz group, PO1N. So that is the positive Lorentz group, right? This is the positive Lorentz group, and we want to describe the geometry of this. So of which proper nice space it is the group of isometry. That is something which you want to describe, JPO1N, right? So let me say something here again. So PO1N, okay. So now I think we described last time again, but I did it very fast and quickly, those things. So that is why I'm doing it slowly here. So O1N. Now remember last time also, I think perhaps I have proved. Okay, so let me say here the properties of PO1N and some example here. So let me see what is PO1N. So first of all, you know, so let me make this definition first. Definition. A set X1, X2, Xn plus 1 subset of Rn plus 1 is called a Lorentz orthonormal basis if what happens, the first thing is that x1l is minus 1 and xil is equal to 1 for I greater than 1 and xijl is equal to 0 for I different from j. So such vectors are called Lorentz orthogonal vector. So it is Lorentz orthogonal and it is Lorentz unit vector, more or less to say. So these are all space like vectors, x1, x2, xn. The only one is the time like vector. And you see that e1, e2, en plus 1 is a such a Lorentz orthonormal basis. So what is e1, e1? E1, e1 is, you know, is minus 1. Right, 100, 100, so that is minus 1, and the rest of the thing you can easily see that this is a Lorentz orthonormal. So now, so you can easily observe, you can easily observe that if you take A belongs to O1n, means what? O1n means so if you take A, so to characterize A belonging to O1n, so write A as rows. So R1 bar, R2 bar, and Rn plus 1 bar here, rows. So if you take this to be row, then A J1n A transpose will be what? So, okay, so what will be, so this is your R1 bar, Rn plus 1 bar, and minus 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, and your here your R1 bar transpose. So these are columns now, R1, Rn plus 1 transpose. So that means what? This is your Ri, the ith row, jth column will be what? Ri bar, and J1n and Rj transpose. So you see here that this is, so therefore you see that R1 bar, so R1 and R1 bar is minus 1, because this is because of this minus 1. This is your minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Right, so R1 bar minus and again R1 bar here, and that is minus 1, so minus 1 will cancel, right? So you see that is your R1 bar, R1 bar here, L is minus 1, and RJ bar is equal to 0. So this simply means that you can easily observe that rows are for a Lorentz orthonormal basis. Rn plus 1, and indeed, as in case of orthogonal, columns also form. Columns convert into the transpose, you'll be getting columns also form Lorentz orthonormal basis. See, in the orthogonal axis geometry, one thing which you must have observed is very important, and that is the Gram-Schmidt process. So here also, we wish to describe Gram-Schmidt process, Lorentz Gram-Schmidt process. Any basis of Rn can be converted into a Lorentz orthonormal basis, right? Any basis can be converted into a Lorentz orthonormal basis using certain operations. So that means you can see that it says something, because if you, any basis means if you take those members as rows, so that is a non-singular matrix. That is a non-singular matrix, and if you convert into a Lorentz orthonormal basis using certain continuous operations, then you will come to the Lorentz matrix O1n. So that is something which we want to observe here. So that is the Lorentz This is something which we want to do. But before that, say one thing here. You see here, there was only one vector for which the Lorentz inner product was minus one, and for all other, the Lorentz inner product are positive one, zero, and Ri, R were space-like vectors. So let me have this definition first here. A subspace V of R n plus 1 is called a time-like subspace if it contains a time-like vector. So for example, in R2, you see that the subspace, if you just say E2EN, this is not a time-like space. E2EN is not a time-like space. So if you add E1, then and only then it is a time-like space. E1, E2, E3, etc. will be a time-like space, or maybe alpha E1 plus, where alpha is positive, E2, etc. that is a time-like space. But a space need not be a time-like space. Vector space need not be a time-like space. So this is a time-like space, our aim is to prove the following theorem. Perhaps we also try to demonstrate this. Let P K R M plus 1 denote the k-dimensional time-like subspaces of Rn plus 1, n plus 1. Then O1n acts transitively on T K R N plus 1, just as the orthogonal group used to act transitively on the Grassmannian K G K R N. So similarly here, but time-like spaces. So it acts transitively on time-like spaces. So that is the thing we observe here. So it acts transitively on time-like space. We further, so that is the time-like space. Now let me, this is something which we wish to prove. So first, proof. So observe that if V is time-like subspace and A is a member of A is a member of O1n, then OAV, so VA is a subspace, because A is a matrix, so V times A, which is your XA, such that X belongs to V, it's a subspace, therefore, is also a time-like, also a time-like subspace. So it's already a subspace. And if there is a vector here, which is time-like, then A preserves the length here, Lorentz length here. So therefore, X bar A is also time-like. So therefore, this is a time-like space. So that means A acts on this space. Okay, on this T, K, R, N plus 1, it acts. Now, we have to show that it acts transitively. So T, K, R, O, 1, N acts transitively. Okay, so now let V be a M-dimensional time-like subspace, or K-dimensional. Dimensional time-like subspace of Rn plus 1. So it is sufficient to show that there is A belonging to O1n such that K cross zero, A is V. So first coordinates, we are taking this. RK, you know, is a time-like space. RK is a time-like space. E1 is here. So time-like space. So this is equal to V. That is what we wish to show here. And then, let me, so it amounts to, suppose somehow we are able to show, suppose that we are able to show the existence of a Lorentz orthonormal basis x1, x2, xk, xk plus 1, xn plus 1, Lorentz orthonormal basis, this, such that V is the subspace generated by x1, x2, xk. Right? So suppose we have a Lorentz orthonormal basis x1, x2, xk, and xk plus 1, xn plus 1, such that this is V, then what you do, you take this A to be this matrix, A to be the matrix whose x1 is the first row, x2 is the second row, and xn plus 1 is the last row. Xn plus 1 is the last row. And then you multiply with this, you will see that it is x1, x2, xk, x1, x2, xn plus 1. Sorry, this is V is equal to this times x1, x2, this times V, this times RK, okay, yeah, I'm sorry. This is your RK cross zero times this, this matrix A is really your subspace generated by x1, x2, xk. Because after this, it will become zero, RK cross zero. You see that this is equal to x1, x2, xk. So therefore, A takes this to this. So the result will follow. So now this will mean what? This is the, really the Lorentz-Gram-Schmidt process. Because you can take a basis here, x1, x2, xk of V and extend it to a basis xn here with x1 being time-like, because this is a time-like space. And then you have to give a process by which you can convert this into a Lorentz orthogonal vector, Lorentz orthonormal basis. So without changing the, so you have to convert this into y1, y2, yk, such that yk plus 1, such that the subspace generated by y1 is the same as x1, yk by x, this up to this. So that is the thing. And this is the Gram-Schmidt process. So I'll do it more explicitly because now I'm running down out. So doing quickly again,
may create problem. So I just stop. I'll do it. Lorentz Gram is the process more effectively. And then describe PO1N as the group of isometry of the hyperbolic standard hyperbolic N space, which is a model HN, which is a model for hyperbolic geometry. Just as RN, you see N manifold, a manifold, which is locally homeomorphic to RN, is a manifold for Euclidean for geometry here, and which is locally something like SN. Geometrically, that is a spherical one, and that is something which is so I'll give you this HN, a model for hyperbolic geometry, RN, HN, and SN. This is for flat, this is for positive curvature, this is for negative curvature. So we'll discuss that this maybe next time. So that is the thing which maybe I'm sorry, I don't know whether I have made it a little. So this theorem I'll again prove maybe next time very explicitly, and describe PO1N as the group of isometry of the hyperbolic space and some properties. After that, I will do what is termed as the spin group. Quickly I'll describe. Indeed, I will describe the construction, which is inherent in to some extent in the construction of the quaternion algebra, the Clifford algebras associated to quadratic forms, and then just as symplectic group, there we'll come to the what is called the spin group, which is a double cover of SOM. So which describes some geometry, which has some geometry property. So that is so. Thank you. Aap log kuch, I'm sorry, I have already taken the full time. So
नहीं सर, बहुत बढ़िया रहा, और बहुत सारे लोग होंगे जो क्लिफर्ड अलजेब्रा की भी आपने बात की और बहुत सारी चीजों की बात की, तो शायद उनको पता ना हो तो वो भी पूछ सकते हैं. अगर कोई टर्म समझ में ना आ रहा हो, किसी डेफिनेशन में दिक्कत है, तो ऑल ऑफ यू कैन आस्क.
यस, आप लोग पूछिए. कोई चीज है इसमें कहीं भी कोई वो थोड़ा हम एक स्ट्रेच में करते गए हैं, बीच बीच में रुके नहीं है, तो कुछ असर तो पड़ता होगा. क्लास की बात और होती है, यहाँ लगता है कि मैं वन वे ट्रैफिक हो जाती है, और फिर मैं भी कुछ हैफजर्ड भी हो जाता हूँ बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, बिकॉज सेवरल थिंग्स कम इन माइंड. सो इट प्रेशराइजेस, यू नो, टू तो ये होता है. अगर आप लोग क्लास में रहता तो बड़ा बढ़िया रहता. खैर चलिए, तो ये है. और आप लोग कुछ पूछना हो तो पूछिए. एनीथिंग फॉर 5 मिनट्स, और फॉर इफ यू हैव एनी, इफ यू
है, अगर नेक्स्ट वीक सर कुछ कह रहे हैं अंकल, नेक्स्ट वीक में नेक्स्ट फ्राइडे को मेरा अगर तैयार हो जाता तो हुर्विस थ्योरम पर लेक्चर दे.
वेरी गुड यार, सो नाइस.
बहुत बढ़िया सर,
सो नाइस. सो
प्योरली अल्जेब्रिक तरीके से है, उसमें कोई टोपोलॉजी नहीं इन्वॉल्व है, और एलिमेंट्री टाइप का है थोड़ा सा.
बहुत अच्छी बात है, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया. तो वेरी गुड हिमाद्री, आई एम सो हैप्पी, और बहुत बढ़िया करो.
नेक्स्ट फ्राइडे सर हम लोग ना.
हाँ
फ्राइडे,
ठीक है सर, बिल्कुल, बहुत ही बढ़िया रहेगा.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, थैंक यू.
उसको मैं वेरी गुड बीमर में तैयार करके बीमर शेयर कर दूंगा, उससे हो जाएगा ना.
जी जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल हो जाएगा,
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. ये लिखना वाला नहीं,
और भी तैयार करो, और भी कुछ करो,
देखते हैं अभी. एक्चुअली
थोड़ा सा बिजी रहेंगे इसमें, कुछ हम लोग और डिस्कस करते रहे बीच-बीच में, तो थोड़ा सा और वो ये. तो बहुत बढ़िया हिमाद्री, आई एम सो हैप्पी. चलो वेरी गुड,
ठीक है. तो आज का सेमिनार यहीं पर एंड करते हैं हम लोग, और नेक्स्ट वीक हिमाद्री सर जो है सेमिनार में रहेंगे, और हम सब तो रहेंगे ही रहेंगे. तो आप सभी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, और नेक्स्ट फ्राइडे 17 दिसंबर को हम सब मिलते हैं. थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू.